Hello everyone, in this video we are going to discuss IP address as part of the pen testing. Any network engineer or any hacking engineer will be knowing this IP address in detail so that they will continue with other terms. So what is IP address? As per the general definition, it goes like internet protocol address. So whenever you make the connection or the network, you need to follow some protocol. So for this we have the internet protocol, so which is nothing but IP address. In layman point of view, it is a numerical label assigned to the each device connected with each other. It can be your local network or it can be your internet. Earlier days we have IPv4 version which has the 32-bit, whereas now we have IPv6 which has the 128 bits. Since we have exhausted the IPv4 almost, we are going with the IPv6. But at the end user, you should be knowing there should be some address for each device for any network to interact with each other. In IPv4 addresses can be looking like something, the numbers separated by the dots and which has the 4 octets. In symbol it will be ranging from 0 to 255 for each part. Whereas IPv6 will be having the numeric as well. For example, it can be hexadecimal, so you can have the different numbers as you see in the screen. But at last, we will be having the unique address for each device. There are a lot of definitions about the IP addresses, but in general we are going to discuss about the private IP addresses and public IP addresses. So whenever you make local area network, in simple, if you are making the simple network inside your home itself, for example you have 2 laptops and 1 desktop and 1 printer and 1 smart TV and 1 speaker. So each device has to be interacting with other devices. In order to interact with other devices, it has to know about that device uniquely. So for that, the IP address will be given to the device and that will be called as a private IP address. Whereas public IP address will be coming into picture when you interact with the network. So network in the sense you are going with the ISP provider. So whenever you have some network, that means that you are using some network provider and they will be called as a ISP, Internet Service Provider. So they will be giving the unique IP address to your laptop or your device. So that will be known to the other people who are interacting outside your network. So that means that the whole internet. In short, private IP address will be inside a network, whereas a public one will be the outside network. In simple, it will be in the internet. So in this video, we are going to see how to see the private IP address and how to see the public IP addresses. In terminal, we are going to see ifconfig, IP address and hostname. These are the commands we are going to see, so that we will understand what is the private address. As we seen, the public address will be given by the ISP, so we can see directly using some websites, for example ifconfig.co. Even if you type in the Google or any browser what is my IP address, it will be showing the public IP address. Either it can be public or private, it can be set by the user in case of private, or it can be edited. Whereas in public address also, the ISP can provide the static IP address or it can be the dynamic IP address. In simple, the static IP address will be costing you more, whereas the dynamic IP will be normal way. The same thing, we can just get what is the public IP address and private IP address by using the Python modules, and the modules names are subprocess, request and BS4, or let's say beautiful soup. So we will be discussing more when you come to the Python modules. First we will start with the terminal. First command we are going to type is ifconfig interface configurations. Here you can see 3 items, I will just maximize. So Ethernet, which will be your internet card, and loopback, so that means that whenever you want to interact with your own system, it has to some IP address. So for that we will be having the 127.0.0.1, so it will be in the local host. And after that we have the WLAN, so it will be working as a Wi-Fi. So in my case, I am connected to the Wi-Fi network, so I can see the WLAN is having the details. The same way you can type IP address, so it will be having the same data but in a color. Here you can see the first one will be loopback and Ethernet and WLAN. Here you can see wherever it has the INET, you can see the IP address for that. So that means that this is the private address of the particular device which I am connecting or which I am working now. The same way you can see the IPv6 version also, that will be here. So you are getting both IP addresses in version 4 and version 6. Let's say if you have connected with a wired network, you will be having the details in under the Ethernet. Let's say you have some other network, so that network also will be connected if you are connected already. So those details will be under this one. We have seen another command called hostname. So hostname, if you type simply I, so it will be showing your local host. Let's say it will be your local host IP address, which will be similar for every system. So that may not be useful for you. Even in documentation of manual page of hostname, you will be seeing to use the IP address, or let's say the hostname -i. Here you can get the same details like what we have seen here. So the IP address of the your private IP address of your system and the version 4 and version 6 details. So this is the IP address of version 6, this is the IP address of version 4. Both you can see by using the hostname -i. For more details you can type, let's say, man hostname. Here you can see what are the details we can use. Here you can see display all network addresses of the host. Even you can see you can use the caps I rather than using the small I. Avoid using this option. So with that we will conclude the terminal section. So by using the commands hostname -caps I, or let's say IP address, or let's say ifconfig, we can get the local IP address. In order to get the public IP address, as we discussed earlier, we will be going to the any browser. For example, now I am typing what is my IP address. You can see the IP address. Now it is having 45.115.90.20. So this IP address will be generally dynamically given IP address by the ISP provider. Let's say if you are connecting to the other network, the IP will be different because the ISP will be different. Let's say if you are switching off your router, or let's say the modem, again if you restart, that time the IP address will be different. So that means that it will be dynamically given to you, so that every time it will be having, or it can be changing at any time. It does not mean that you can do some illegal activities by using this IP address, because they will be having the track of which IP address was given to which person on which particular time. For example, if you go to any offices, there will be parking lot for the working people whom they are working there, right? The same way there will be a guest area where there will be a parking lot. So it does not mean that in a guest parking lot you can do some illegal parking, because they will be having the clear tracking who are parking on which time on the guest parking lot. The same way here also, the dynamic IP address will be tracked very closely, so that you can be tracked very easily on which activities you are doing something illegal. Okay, this is about the public IP address. But we have seen some sample site, which is nothing but ifconfig, right? So ifconfig.co. It will be having some more information, so just we will see that. Here you can see, this is the site, you can see what is your public IP address, and IP address and country and other details, your let's say browser names, or let's say time zone. And you can use the curl command also, in case if you want to use in the command line. This is another way. And you can see the some more information about your let's say IP address and the ISP provider and so on. So as we discussed earlier, now we have seen all the things by using the terminal. ifconfig, IP address, hostname. With all these three, we have seen the private IP address. By using some external sites, we have seen the public IP address. Now we are going to do the same thing in Python modules. I hope everyone knows about the basics about the Python module, so that I am just going to directly start from the coding area. First we will see the private IP address. As we discussed earlier, we have seen using the hostname will be the very shortcut, right? Because other things will be having more output, so you need to have the more string manipulation over the output. Rather than doing those things, we can directly use the hostname -i. But however, we have executed via terminal. In this case, we can execute any terminal commands inside your Python code by using the module called a subprocess. So subprocess.run, and whatever the command you have used inside your terminal, that command can be given here. In case if you want to see the same output like shell, you need to give the shell is equal to true. In other cases, let's say if you want to capture the output, what are the things you are getting as a standard output you want to capture, you can mention capture output is equal to true. After doing this, the output will be captured here. However, the output will be giving same like our terminal, it will be giving all the things. For example, all the things in the sense version 4 and version 6. We need to have only the version 4. In that case, you will be using, let's say, split command by using the space, because the version 4 and version 6 will be separated with the space. After separated, you will be having the first value. So for that, I am giving the index as 0 and you will be getting. You might be wondering why I have given the decode. Because by default, it will be giving the binary format. You need to convert into the ASCII format. So for that purpose, I have given the ASCII. And after that, I am going to print the internal IP address. So let's execute this one and see how it goes. Here you can see. There are a lot of other more ways are there. For example, if you are really very known about the, let's say, the terminal commands or let's say Linux commands, the pipe symbol you can use. For example, IP address we have seen, right? So IP address, pipe symbol, that means that this input will be given to the next level. There we are doing the grep command. It will be like a, let's say, the regular expression. It will be looking for the word. So for the word, we need to give the hyphen W, and wherever it has the inet, the word, it will be taken that line. And after that, we are printing AWK. So AWK is the another language inside your, let's say, Linux commands. There you will be printing something from the second field. And you will be having the total output as the IP address. Even this will work in the same way. Even subprocess run, as we have seen the curl command also, we can use it. We can use the same thing. For just demo purpose, I will just execute this one as well. And execute the same. Here you can see the same outputs. Even it comes with your port numbers as well. But however, the IP address will be remaining same. So however, curl config will be giving the public IP address that we discussed from external side. So as of now, I will command this one. Other output, let's say subprocess, though, that will be giving the same IP address. I think we need to run it again. Here you can see the same IP address for the private IP address. Curl config co, let's say curl config, curl ifconfig.co, it is the third external party. So that's the reason we are getting the public IP address here. So now we have commanded that one. So we are seeing the same output here. Okay, let's go to the public IP address. So public IP address we have seen via the external website. So from the external website, you need to get the data. It will be generally called as a web scrapping. In Python, there are a lot of modules available to do the web scrapping. But in general, we are going to use the Beautiful Soup is one of the web scrapping module inside the Python. Along with that, we are going to use the request.get. So request.get will be giving the IP address, let's say the website. Sorry for the interruption. So we'll be using the request module to get the output or to get the response from the particular URL. For example, we are going to use the http://ifconfig.co. So from that we are getting the response, and after that we are passing that response content, and we are going to parse as a HTML parsing, and we are calling the HTML soup. So that will be giving the object, which is nothing but the soup object. From the soup object, we are going to get the class. So wherever the parameter or say the tag name and the argument parameter name as IP, that value we are going to get, and we are getting the text value for that. And we will be getting the value inside the variable called public IP, and we are displaying the public IP address. So let's run this and see how it goes. Here we are getting the public IP address. Just we will compare with the actual output here. So the IP address is 45.115.90.20. Even if you want to inspect this one, you can see here. Here you can see IP address. Directly you can inspect here. It has the class argument. It will be having the IP. So actually it's not argument, it's the attribute. Class attribute will be having IP, and the text value for that is 45.115.90.20. That's the same thing we are getting here. So this way also we can get the public address from the third party websites. So this is about the IP addresses, public and private, and we have seen the theory part also. So thanks all, thanks for watching, and have a great day.